Normally, when you hear the name McDonald's, you probably think about cheeseburgers, chicken nuggets, french fries, or the fact that there is a McDonald's on every single street corner in the universe. Of course, when you're a company as huge as McDonald's, there's bound to be some snakes in the grass trying to troll and or meme your company, and that's exactly what happened in this past week with something that I'm going to be listing as one of the greatest trolls of 2017. Now, this comes directly from Twitter, and it is seemingly innocent at first. You know, just another food account doing food-related things. In this case, McDonald's Hong Kong. They were tweeting out actual food things from their menu. They were talking about come visit our stores, try out our new delivery services. They were even tweeting links to the official Hong Kong McDonald's service. Whoever had control of this account really made it seem believable. They went all out on everything that they possibly could have. The only big red flags were the fact that it wasn't verified or the fact that it was tweeting in English. That was kind of weird to me. But it all kind of crumbled when this post came out here. I miss her so fucking much. Fuck this job. Where is my wife and where is my son? No one hurts this pretty girl but her. Okay, just weird. I mean, kind of weird. A lot of people thought, oh, well, maybe this person was tweeting from their personal account and they accidentally put it on the Hong Kong account. What made it even more strange is the fact that after this went out, it wasn't deleted, but they followed up with another tweet talking about come in and try their new food. It was just like they carried on and completely avoided the fact that they had just tweeted that out. It was kind of strange. So then this is where the rabbit hole gets deeper and darker and really more confusing. The official and verified McDonald's Corporation account actually tweeted at McDonald's Hong Kong saying, "We like our weekends with waffle and taro ice cream. How are you cooling off this weekend at McDonald's Hong Kong?" Thinking it was a legitimate account, or maybe it is in fact, or was in fact a legitimate account. We'll talk a little bit more about that theory in just a moment. McDonald's Hong Kong went ahead and quoted that, saying, "I would like my weekends if she just called me back for once. All I do is wait." Surprisingly, this is not photoshopped. This is actually a legit tweet. I took the screenshot and I verified myself that it was legitimate. It's since been deleted, by the way, so you can't find it anymore. I just find it baffling to me that the official McDonald's account thought that this person trolling was a legitimate McDonald's account because of all of their previous tweets, and then all of a sudden shit hit the fan. I think McDonald's realized that they made a mistake and deleted this really, really quickly before it got any more exposure. But the tweets don't end there from the Hong Kong account. They went on to say and concern a lot of people by posting, "Where is my son? They took my son." Seriously, are we in some sort of situation where we're having Rush Hour happen all over again? If you guys watched the original Rush Hour, by the way, very good movie. Check it out. But seriously, like, this is, a lot of people made articles about this. There were people actually, like, calling, trying to figure out what the heck is going on. And it kind of blew up into this huge media sandstorm. And that's when you saw websites like Gizmodo and Kotaku and all these other article pieces about the Hong Kong account. As soon as it started getting more traction from the media, then the tweets became a little more erratic, I guess you could say. We had one right here. It says, "I want to quit. She left me." Not so bad. But the next tweet right after that, "Please kill me. I wish to die." I know the McFlurry machine isn't working, but it's not worth it, dude. Now, since these articles started to gain massive attention, people were reaching out to McDonald's trying to get an official answer, and finally, about 4 or 5 hours later, a McDonald's spokesperson came out and said that this was indeed a troll or a fake account, and it will be removed very soon. Unfortunately, that is where our saga ends. The McDonald's Hong Kong account has officially been removed, but now there's like a ton of other ones that popped up, and they're trying to do the same exact thing, so They're not very good at it. I mean, some of the tweets are funny, but they're not gonna gain traction like this last one did, because the last one, you know, it kind of went in undercover. It made it seem like it was on their side, you know, constantly tweeting, and even had the trust of the official McDonald's Corporation account until they went down and slapped it and just completely went crazy with the account. Now that is the work of a beautiful troll. Now, a lot of people might be wondering, why would McDonald's confuse this account? If it wasn't verified, they should have known it wasn't theirs. If you do a quick, simple search of McDonald's on Twitter, you'll find that there are a lot of accounts that are in regard to specific regions, specific countries for McDonald's that aren't yet verified, but they are, in fact, legitimate, or at least That's what we think they are. It could have been just a misunderstanding on the corporation's end, thinking that maybe this was, in fact, a legitimate account, just like all the other ones are that aren't verified. And, of course, that's why they gave them a little bit of exposure. My theory, though, I feel is a little bit more interesting. This probably was a real account at one point. Maybe this was a legitimate account. It still doesn't kind of explain the fact that they were tweeting out English when it's supposed to be a Hong Kong account. But regardless of that, it could have been possibly an American worker that had control of the account that was tweeting things about Hong Kong and, of course, linking the website. And maybe they did go rogue. Maybe they just kind of snapped one day and thought to themselves, you know, screw this account. Screw this job. I'm just going to go ahead and make my own story. I'm going to go ahead and take these followers and tell them how I truly feel. And that's when they started talking about my son this, my son that. And still, if that is all true and that was actually someone that was suffering because their wife left them or their girlfriend or whatever and they took the son, that's terrible. But then on the other side of things, what if this wasn't actually a situation where it was serious? Like, maybe, sure, they were just 100% troll and they were just trolling. I wonder if they would have been able to keep their account if they actually put parody in the description of the Twitter account. I know that there are tons and tons of celebrity parodies and celebrity impersonation accounts on Twitter that inevitably get to keep whatever they do on there because they have parody listed right then and there in the description or in the bio of the Twitter account. I mean, as per Twitter rules, if they did that, technically they would have been able to keep their account, but I wonder if McDonald's would have taken that extra step to say, you know what? No, this is our brand. This is our integrity. We're going to go ahead and we're going to take you to court and you're going to pay out the ass because we have lawyers up and down the street, just like as many as McDonald's we got up and down the street. But I don't know. It's just definitely a weird situation overall. I thought it was kind of jarring to see that the tweets themselves stayed up for so long if it was an actual legitimate account. At the end of the day, it was most likely just a very, very intuitive troll that ended up doing something much greater with his fantastic work of deception and deceiving. And I think the worst part for McDonald's as a corporation, this can happen to them again. I think for sure they're going to be double, triple, quadruple checking every single account they decide to publicly tweet from their official McDonald's Corporation account. But since there are so many unverified McDonald's accounts, they could technically slip up and make the same mistake. I mean, for example, there's already a new Hong Kong McDonald's that has been created, probably by a troll, but who knows, maybe it's the official McDonald's account. And once again, I know we've already kind of touched on it, but this could be a total controversy in the fact that maybe this was a legitimate account. Maybe McDonald's didn't notice what they were tweeting, and they did go through and support them by tweeting them on the official McDonald's Corporation, and then realized what kind of nonsense they were doing. Ended up getting the account removed, pushing it under the rug, and just making everyone think it was a troll, and in fact, now you see me here making this video today. It is a really interesting thing to think about because it can go one of two ways. McDonald's has so much money that they can basically make anything happen if they wanted to. They can make people disappear, I'm sure, if they really wanted to. Grind them up in the meat and put them in the burgers and make people eat it, but that would be disgusting. On the other hand, it probably was just one of the greatest trolls of 2017. But anyway, guys, let me know what you think down below in the comment section. If you enjoyed today's video, please leave a like down below. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And once again, just kind of want to touch base for this last minute of the video. You know, stretch it to the 10-minute mark just like every other YouTuber does. But a lot of people have been asking me why I haven't been uploading my main type of content like Call of Duty and stuff like that. It's because I'm bored of it. I'm sick of doing Call of Duty. I don't mind uploading it, but as of right now, in this kind of like dead space between Call of Duty World War II and of course Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, I'm so bored of it. I don't want to play it anymore. I'm enjoying playing other games. I'm having fun doing other things, and it's just not my main focus right now. I feel like when I play the game itself, I waste a lot of time because I'm playing something that I don't enjoy uploading, if that makes any sense. Like, even as a gameplay, usually what I talk about has nothing to do with the game anymore, right? Like, even previously when I'm just making standard commentaries about everything else, I'm never really focused on whatever game I'm playing. I either have, like, Infinite Warfare in the background or whatever, but people just don't like that. They don't seem to enjoy that type of content anymore. So I've been trying to shift and change up some of the things that I've been doing and A lot of you seem to enjoy it. I've been seeing a ton of new subscribers and new followers come in because of it, and I definitely don't mind doing that for you guys, especially who enjoy me as a personality and not just the game that's in the background. So anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching today's video. Once again, drop a like if you enjoyed, subscribe for more, and of course, I will see you on the next one. Peace.